At this point in my life, NoFap is pretty much useless, and honestly, it might be useless to you and provide no benefits. Now, before you leave an angry comment and a dislike on this video, let me explain this journey. When I started my NoFap journey almost a year ago, I was in a much worse place than I am now. I would fap just about every single day, and I would watch dirty websites absolutely every single day. I definitely had an addiction to this, and after doing a little bit of research into NoFap in the community, I decided to give it a shot, and it really did change my life. I no longer had a skewed, unrealistic view of women. I had more confidence and more energy, and I found pleasure in the more simpler things of life. When you watch porn all the time, several things happen to you. Many studies have been conducted to see the results of excessive porn use on the brain or just on your well-being, and most of them have concluded that the more that you watch porn and the more you have an addiction to it, the more likely you are to be depressed and the more likely you are to have less sexual satisfaction with your partner. Hence why I say excessive porn usage can lead you to not be able to get it up, because not only does it lead to depression, but like I said, it's gonna skew your kind of view on women. Then you're gonna get into an actual situation and it's not gonna feel the same or be the same. And as a result, you're not gonna be able to get it up. And so with the whole NoFap experience benefiting my life, I decided to try retention for 90 days. And that was also an incredible experience. I felt like I was laser focused in on my work and I had more energy and happiness than I had in a long time. It seemed like all of this stuff was positively impacting every area of my life. So why did I stop? First, let's take you to when I first moved into this house that I'm in right now in Las Vegas, which was around late November. Now, I didn't really have any other option than to do retention when I got here, unless I wanted to take the risk of going up to girls and trying to meet girls during a pandemic. So it was either continue to do retention or what's considered hard mode of NoFap, or start fapping again. And so about 2 months ago, for the first time in several months, I decided to fap. I've had sex since then, but this was the first time fapping in months, and I felt amazing afterwards. There was none of that guilt that I used to feel after I did it. There was no like brain fog. It was just something positive. And so I want to take you through why this is and why I think that NoFap is not going to bring any benefits to some people, and what type of people should actually be doing some sort of NoFap. Okay, first off, I don't think that NoFap or retention, anything like that, gives you like superpowers. Like, people claim that you're able to attract women easier and there's just like, it's easier to manifest. I don't believe in any of that stuff anymore. The superpowers you feel, I feel, are from if you were like addicted to porn and excessive masturbation, and you stop doing that and stop getting that type of dopamine, then you just focus on your other areas of life and that boosts your confidence. And when your confidence boosts, your libido boosts, and it's a snowball effect like that where it's just gonna be amazing. But to say if you do NoFap, you're gonna be successful in life or you're gonna attract more women, that's just not true. You have to have confidence and you have to be willing to go up to women and get rejected a lot of times to build that confidence. It's not gonna come if you just stop jacking off and watching porn. NoFap forces you to take that time that you allotted to doing those things and instead put it towards more productive things, or that's what people usually do. And confidence is really the backbone of everything in life, of increasing libido, energy, happiness, and that's where I feel like the superpowers of NoFap come from. There's a lot of other factors that could have gone into me feeling like I was manifesting things easier during this time. It wasn't just because I was holding in my seed. Another problem I've identified with NoFap is that when you relapse, because this does happen to a lot of people, you feel so awful about yourself. So awful about yourself that you wouldn't feel if you hadn't even known what NoFap is. And that's what I feel like is the problem with the NoFap mindset. You're so rigidly stuck to, I can't watch a single piece of porn, or I can't jack off once, or else I'm gonna feel awful about myself, and then you're gonna lower your confidence. It's just, it ruins you when you're so dedicated to NoFap and you relapse. Whereas if you weren't dedicated at all, but if you just watch porn sometimes or just jacked off sometimes, it would be zero problem. If you relapse, it's really not something to feel guilty about, especially if you've been doing it for so long. You're not gonna lose your superpowers, your retention superpowers. You might have been on this NoFap thing for quite a while now, and you're like, I don't see any superpowers, I don't see any results, I don't see any change in my life, what's happening? Two things could be happening here. The first one is the thing that I went over, it just might not be for you. It might not give you any sort of benefits, or you might be in case number two where you started watching porn at a very young age and you started masturbating at a very young age. It's going to take you quite a while to overcome this addiction and get over those brain changes that all that stuff has made you feel. It is like overcoming an addiction, and those things take months and months. So if you've only been doing it for like 30 days, it might not be long enough if you started this addiction so early. NoFap is for people addicted to porn and excessive masturbation, period. If you even look at NoFap, like the official NoFap website or the official NoFap people community, whatever the hell it is, they will tell you that the problem isn't in you jacking off, it's in you doing PMO, which stands for porn masturbation orgasm. What PMO is when you actively decide to masturbate to dirty websites. And that can absolutely decrease your happiness and your drive for life. It does really suck the life out of you when you do those two things together. But if you're only jacking off or masturbating every once in a while, it can actually be healthy. If you do it every once in a while, let's say like once a week, it can help reduce stress, it can help balance your libido levels. And this is really what I found. I really want to tell you guys about this. When I decided to start jacking off again, now I do it like once every week or once every couple weeks, I find that my libido really increases for that week. You know, there is a saying, I even saw someone commented on my retention video, it's like, use it or lose it. And I kind of agree with that, because when I was doing retention after that whole 90-day reboot period that I had, that it really had a significant impact on me, I was actually starting to feel negative effects from retention. Like, I was doing retention for several weeks and I just felt no libido at all, nothing like that. And once I started doing it once every week, I feel like I have more libido, more sexual energy, and sexual energy is something that you do need, especially as a man, because it does drive you to want to work harder and allows you to have more energy and want to do more stuff. And so I know the detrimental effects of watching porn or watching too much of it, and so I'm going to continue not doing that. But at this point in my life, it feels as though fapping once a week when I'm not sexually active is good for me. It feels good. I feel great afterwards. And it feels like I have more libido now. This channel will always be about me sharing my experience through life and what's made me live my most optimal life. And so you're gonna find that optimal experience is gonna change over time, and I'm gonna change my opinions on some topics that I talk about. And some things that I talk about will work for you, or they might not help you at all. And that's kind of what I wanna clear up here and wanna tell you. As always, thank you to all my patrons on Patreon. You can go to patreon.com/ColeHastings or go to the link in my description to get exclusive content from me, as well as personal one-on-one advice. Yeah, go check it out, link in the description. I'm putting out good, juicy content there as well. Leave your comments below on the subject, and if you agree or disagree with me and your experience with NoFap, that'll be it. Go check out my other videos on this subject to see how much I've changed my opinion about all these things. And yeah, that's it. I'll see you guys in the next video. Love ya.